Good morning, everyone. We are starting with semester 6, which is the international cuisine. So our first menu is a Chinese menu. The menu is hot and sour soup, vegetable spring rolls. Then we have Sichuan chicken. For vegetarians, we are making Sichuan paneer. And we have Hakka noodles, again, which can be egg Hakka noodles or veg Hakka noodles. So let's have a look at the division of ingredients and we will start with our pre-preparation. Alright, so for the hot and sour soup, we need a chicken stock. For the chicken stock, we have to prepare a Chinese stock, for which we need chicken bones. We have some spring onion, we have some ginger, and we have the trimming of the vegetables that are going to go in the stock. For the soup, we have some capsicum or green peppers, we have some cabbage, we have some garlic, we have some carrot, we have mushrooms, and we have sweet corn. So we are going to process the vegetables and keep them ready for the soup. Next, we are going to look at the vegetable spring roll. For the vegetable spring roll, we have the spring roll sheets which are ready made. For the filling, we have some spring onions, we have button mushrooms, we have shiitake mushrooms, we have some garlic, we have some tofu, we have some cabbage and some bean sprouts. For the main course, for Sichuan chicken, we have the chicken breast here. We are going to cut them into neat dices and then we are going to marinate it. Similarly, for the Sichuan paneer, we are going to cut them into dices and marinate it. And for the marination, we are going to use some ginger garlic paste. And other ingredients are from the common table. For the Sichuan sauce that we are going to prepare, we have some garlic, we have some ginger, we have some celery, we have red chili paste, we have some tomato ketchup and some spring onions. So these are the ingredients for the Sichuan chicken or Sichuan paneer. And for the last dish, that is Hakka noodles, we have the noodles here. These are the Chinese egg noodles and these are the vegetarian noodles. For vegetables that we are going to put in the noodles, we have some garlic, we have some ginger, we have some spring onion, bulbs and greens, we have some bamboo shoot, we have red and yellow peppers and we have pok choy. Okay, for the non-vegetarian noodles, we have some egg that will be added towards the end. So next we go on to processing of the vegetables. So next what we are going to do is we are going to occupy the gas ranges and then start cutting the vegetables. On one gas range we are going to start with the stock and on the other gas range we are going to keep water for boiling for the noodles. Okay, so let's go on to the gas range. Okay, so on one gas range we will keep half a stock pot of water. To this I am going to add the bones and wait for the water to come to a boil. Once the water is boiled, you will see some impurities or scum that will float on top. That has to be removed and then we will add the flavoring ingredients like ginger, like spring onions. On the other gas range, I've kept water. Okay, I'm going to cover it with a lid. Once the water comes to a boil, I'm going to add some salt and I'm going to add the vegetable noodles inside. Once the vegetable noodles are boiled, then I'm going to add the egg noodles. So next we are starting with the marination of the meats and the paneer. For the marination, I am going to take a steel bowl. To the steel bowl, I am going to add some ginger garlic paste. I am going to add some salt. I am going to add some white pepper powder. I am going to add very little sugar. I am going to add 2 tablespoons of vinegar. I'm going to add some soya sauce, around 1.5 tablespoons of soya sauce. Now I'm going to mix all the ingredients together. Once your marinade is ready, the same marinade can be used for the cottage cheese as well as the chicken. So next I'm going to go to process the cottage cheese. One more ingredient to be added, some chili paste. Once you've added the chili paste, mix it well and your marinade is ready. So next I'm going to start with processing the cottage cheese. I'm going to cut them into cubes and add it to the marinade. Next, we lightly mix the cottage cheese without breaking them. Mix the marinade well. Put a lid on top and keep it in the refrigerator for an hour or so. Alright, going back to the gas range, as you can see here, the water for the stock has come to a boil. I will reduce the flame and remove all the impurities. For this, I need either a kachra bowl or a steel bowl in which there is water, with a frying spoon so that I can remove all these impurities. These impurities have to be removed so that the stock can be nice and clear. Alright, so once we are done skimming, next what we will do is we will add the flavoring ingredients. So all the leftover trimmings that you have will be added here to the stock. Similarly, for flavoring we are going to add some crushed ginger. And we are going to add a whole spring onion with the bulb and the green. Okay, leave it inside. Keep it on a low flame for another 20 minutes for simmering. Coming back to the cutting board, next we start processing the chicken for remove the excess fat. Cut them into neat dices and add them to the marinade. We've already prepared the marinade and kept it ready. I'm just going to cut them into neat dices and add it to the marinade. So mix the chicken pieces into the marinade and then leave it in the refrigerator for another hour. Alright, so while the chicken and the cottage cheese is marinating, let's go on to the next job, which is the spring rolls. For the spring rolls, we need to cut the vegetables, we need to saute the vegetables and then allow it to cool down before we can actually fill it into the spring rolls. So let's have a look at the cut of the vegetables. We have some mushrooms here. I'm just going to slice the mushrooms. So while we were cutting the vegetables, I realized that the water has come to a boil. So it's time for the noodles to go into the salted boiling water. As you know, I have two noodles here. I have the veg noodles and the egg noodles. What I will do is I will add the veg noodles first. I'll allow the noodles to come to a boil and this will take around 4 to 5 minutes of boiling. So I will leave the lid open and allow the noodles to boil. When the noodles is boiled, then I'm going to drain out the noodles and separate it out on a plate and drizzle some oil on top. And simultaneously I'll use the same water for boiling the egg noodles as well. Okay, so going back to the table. Going on to the shiitake mushrooms. Shiitake mushrooms has to be cut into julienne. So I'll transfer all the shiitake here onto the cutting board and then cut them into julienne. Alright, so as you can see here, the noodle is boiled. In order to check, we will break the noodle and see. Okay, so remove the noodle, remove the excess water. Remove the noodle in a pie dish. And then I'm going to drizzle some vegetable oil. And using a spoon or a fork, I'm just going to spread out the noodles so that they can cool down and they do not stick to each other. In the same water, what I'm going to do is I'm going to add the egg noodles. So drop them in. I'm going to turn off the flame. I'm going to put a lid. Leave it covered for another 5 minutes. By the time the noodle will be cooked, we will remove it. Again in another pie dish, drizzle some oil and leave it out. Alright, so as you can see here, the stock has been simmering for 20 minutes now. So I'm going to turn off the flame and I'm going to drain out the stock using a soup strainer and a muslin. So continuing with the cutting of the vegetables for the vegetable spring roll. What I have here is tofu. Okay, so I'm going to just cut the tofu into julienne, but slightly fatter so that it doesn't break. Moving on to the spring onions, we will keep the bulbs as it is separate. Okay, cut them into half, further cut them into quarter. Lastly, finely chop the garlic. Okay, first crush the garlic and then chop the garlic. So all the vegetables for the vegetable spring roll have been processed and kept ready. Next we will go onto the gas range and start sauteing the vegetables for the vegetable spring roll. Next we are going to start with sauteing the vegetables for the spring roll. Okay, so I'm going to take a wok. This is a seasoned wok to which I'm going to add a tablespoon of sesame seed oil. Okay, heat up the oil and then add the garlic. Fry the garlic. Then add the mushrooms, followed by the bean sprouts and the cabbage. Once the cabbage and the mushrooms are sauteed, then you will add the tofu and the spring onion. Following which I'm going to add the seasoning, so some salt, some white pepper powder, some sugar, some soya sauce, very little soya sauce, I don't want the filling to become nice and dark. Okay, so some soya sauce, and we're lightly going to mix it. And I'm going to add some white vinegar. Toss the vegetables for a minute or so and then remove it on a plate and allow it to cool down. Once it cools down, then we are going to fill it inside the spring roll sheet. Coming back to the table where we will prep for the soup and for the Szechuan sauce. Alright. Now as you can see, both our gas ranges are free now. Okay, so we need to prep for the soup and the Szechuan sauce. So we'll just cut the vegetables and then go back to the gas range and work on the sauce and the soup. I'm going to chop the garlic finely. Next we go on to the ginger, again cut the ginger finely chopped for the Szechuan sauce. Right, next we will chop the celery finely, again for the Szechuan sauce. Right, so next we process the spring onion for the Szechuan chicken and Szechuan paneer. The whites have to be cut into diamonds, slightly bigger. Simultaneously, the spring onion greens also we have to cut into diamonds. For the garnish, we are going to place the spring onion diamonds in water and maybe keep it in the refrigerator for it to become nice and crisp. The spring onion whites will go back on the plate, which will be added to the Sichuan chicken or the Sichuan paneer, and the excess spring onions that we are left with will be used for the noodles. Alright, so for the soup, I'm going to process the carrot. I'm going to cut it into julienne, the thin slices first. Mushrooms have to be cut into thin slices. So keep them whole, nice and thin slices. Even the capsicum and the cabbage has to be cut into julienne. Now that we are ready with the vegetables for the soup and for the Sichuan chicken. Okay, so now we go on to the gas range, where I will start on one gas range. I will start with the Sichuan sauce, and on the other gas range I will start making the soup. Starting with the Sichuan sauce, I am heating a wok. To the wok I am going to add oil. Once the oil is nicely heated, then I am going to add the garlic. Saute the garlic lightly, after which you will add the ginger. As you can see, the garlic is getting nice and golden brown. At this stage, I am going to add the ginger and continue frying the ginger. Then add in the celery. Now I'm going to add the chili paste. Making a common Sichuan sauce for the paneer and the chicken. Okay, so I'm going to make a little extra. Now continue cooking the chili paste for another 15 to 20 minutes. At any point, if you feel that it starts to burn, you will add some water to it. In case you want to replace the water, you can add some chicken stock as well. While the sauce is getting ready, let's start with the soup. For the soup, you are going to start with the chili oil. In order to prepare chili oil, you heat up the oil and add whole chilies, warm it up and leave it for some time and then strain. So our chili oil is ready. To the chili oil, I am going to add the garlic. Now for this hot and sour soup, the hotness is going to be provided with the chili oil that we are going to add, the pepper that we are going to add, and the ginger that has gone in the stock. Okay, so for the hotness of the hot and sour soup, we have some chili oil, we have some crushed pepper, and we have some ginger that has been added to the stock. For sourness, we are going to add the vinegar. Alright, so once the oil is heated, I am going to add the garlic. Lightly fry the garlic. Alright, so as you can see here, the garlic is starting to brown. Now on a high flame, I am going to add the vegetables. Just shock the vegetables and then add the stock. This will provide a nice color to the vegetables. At the same time, we will make sure that the vegetables don't overcook and maintain the crunch. So I am going to just shock the vegetables in hot oil and then I am going to add the stock. Once we've added the stock inside, now we're going to add all the seasoning. So I'm going to start with some salt. I'm going to add some crushed pepper. I'm going to add a pinch of sugar to balance the flavors. I'm going to add some vinegar, which will provide to the sourness. And I'm going to add some soy sauce. Mix it all together, let it come to a boil, check the seasoning, and then prepare a corn flour slurry to thicken the soup. While the soup is coming to a boil, we will check on the Szechuan sauce. Make sure it doesn't burn on the side, so keep stirring it. Allow the chili to cook. Chili will take around 15 to 20 minutes to cook, and you should see oil floating on top or the chili leaving the oil from the side. As you can see, the soup is coming to a boil. We had some mushroom pot liquor, the dried mushrooms that we had. Okay, so the mushroom pot liquor is being added here for flavor. Simultaneously, as you can see here, chili paste is getting cooked. So at this stage, I'm going to add some more water to convert it into a sauce. This stage, I'm going to add some tomato ketchup as well. This will be used for balancing the flavor to provide some sweetness. Leave it on a low flame, and we are going to work on the corn flour slurry. For the corn flour slurry, we have some corn flour here, we have some water here, and we have a bowl. I'm going to take 1 tablespoon of corn flour, to which I'm going to add around a tablespoon of water. And mix it well. You will see that the corn flour slurry is ready. Okay, don't add too much of water to the corn flour slurry, otherwise the corn flour slurry becomes very thin, and then more of the corn flour slurry has to be added to the soup or to the sauce to make it thick. So you check the seasoning for the soup. Alright, now it's time to thicken the soup. Prepare the slurry. I'm going to add the slurry. Now, one thing to remember here, the slurry has to be added while the soup is boiling. Okay, otherwise you'll form lumps in the soup. Okay, so while it is boiling, you will add drops of slurry. Mix it well. Check for the seasoning. Again, if needed, add more slurry. Mix it well. Check the seasoning. Understand, the corn flour slurry thickens the soup very fast. So add little at a time and check immediately if you have the right consistency. We will stop adding the slurry. You can see here, this is of the right consistency. I'm going to just show you the consistency. Alright, so the Szechuan sauce is ready. We will just thicken the sauce by adding some corn flour slurry. Sauce is ready. I'll turn off the flame, and once the chicken and the cottage cheese has been coated with some corn flour and fried in oil, we are going to add it to the sauce. Next, we start with coating the cottage cheese. So for coating the cottage cheese, I'm adding some corn flour to the cottage cheese. I'm going to lightly mix the corn flour to the cottage cheese. See that there is a thin coating of corn flour on top of the cottage cheese. I'm just going to sprinkle some water to make it into a batter. I'm going to add some rice flour that will add to the crunch when we fry the cottage cheese. Okay, so add the cottage cheese to the hot oil. Fry the cottage cheese till nice and crisp and light golden in color. Once the cottage cheese has been fried, we will directly add it to the sauce. Once you've added the cottage cheese, lightly mix it in the sauce and keep it aside. We will garnish with spring onion at the time of service. The marinated chicken, I'm going to add the egg. Mix the egg to the chicken and then add corn flour, form it into a batter. Next, we are going to fry it in oil. Take the chicken. The chicken will take around 7 minutes to cook. So once the chicken is cooked, we will remove it out. And then add this to the Sichuan sauce. Mix it well, and at the time of service, we will garnish it with spring onion greens. Now that we are done with the soup, that is the Hotan Sa soup and chicken and paneer Sichuan, we will go on to prepping the vegetables for the veg hakka noodles and the egg hakka noodles. Once we are done prepping the vegetables for the noodles, then we go on to making the spring rolls. So let's have a look at the vegetables. Next we are chopping the ginger finely for the noodles. Next we are working on the bamboo shoot. Cut the bamboo shoot into batons or length, cut them lengthwise. Don't cut them very small, they should be visible in the noodle when you are eating the noodle. Simultaneously cut the peppers, again cut the peppers lengthwise. Cut the pokcha into triangles. Alright, so let's start shaping the spring roll sheets. Take the sheet, cut it into quarters. We'll have four small spring rolls ready. Okay. Whenever we're using spring rolls, make sure that you keep it covered at all times because it tends to get dry. Okay. Now we have the filling ready. This is the filling that we had prepared for the wet spring rolls. What we've done is we've prepared a slurry of refined flour and water that will be used for sticking the spring rolls. So we'll take one sheet, spring roll. Take the filling.
And you'll take some slurry and put it on the sides. Now, in order to fold the spring rolls, you lift the flap, fold it inside and pull it back. Press it. Press the sides. Similarly on the other side, press it and fold and then roll it tight. Another way of making the spring roll sheets or wrapping the spring rolls by putting the filling in the center. This time, instead of taking the back flap on top, what we do is we seal it from the sides. So take the side flap, cover the filling. Again take the side flap, cover the filling. And then take the back flap and roll it tightly, making sure that you seal the ends. Once you've done that, just roll it once and your spring roll is ready. Next we are trying to make a wonton. Now for the wonton, as you can see, these are rectangular sheets. We need square sheets. So what I'll do is I'll first cut them into a square sheet. We have the square sheet ready. Now in order to prepare a wonton, what we do is we keep the wonton like this, the sheet, spring roll sheet like this, put the filling in the center. If you put the filling in the center, use the slurry to cover all four sides. And take the diagonally opposite flap or the corner flap, lift it and put it on the corner and press the sides. Then you lift it. These are wontons. These can be steamed or it can be fried. We start with steaming the wontons. I'm going to take some oil and make sure that I brush the oil evenly into the steamer. Okay, so that the wontons after steaming do not stick to the steamer. What I'm going to do is I'm going to place the wontons inside. Make sure the wontons don't touch each other. Otherwise, after cooking, they tend to stick. Place them. Now the steamer is ready. I'm going to open the steamer. The water is boiling. Place the steamer inside. I'm going to sprinkle some water. And I'm going to let it cover and cook for 15 minutes. Next, we'll start with the veg hakka noodles. For the veg hakka noodles, I'm going to heat up the wok. Okay, I'm going to add some sesame oil to this. Sesame oil provides a very nice flavor to the noodles that you are preparing. If you feel the amount of sesame oil is a little too much, you can reduce. Right. Now to this, what I am going to do is I have got some vegetables here. I have got some garlic, I have got some ginger. Okay, I am going to add this and saute these vegetables. Then I am going to add some spring onion whites, some colored capsicum, some pok choy. Toss the vegetables and add the noodles. Add the seasoning and I will be done. Let's have a look at this. Thank you. fry the garlic and ginger till it becomes nice and crisp and gets a nice golden color. Then you can add the spring onions, add the colored capsicum, bok choy, salt, the amount of vegetables is more, you can sprinkle some water. Here the quantity is quite less. The sauce, now the principles of Chinese cooking that we learned is high temperature, short time cooking. So you work with high temperature and the cooking time is very short, so that the vegetables have a very nice color and very nice texture. Okay, and once you are done, I'm going to add the noodles and I'm going to quickly add the seasoning. This is the salt, white pepper powder, pinch of sugar, very little soya sauce and wee bit of vinegar. A little bit of spring onion leaves and we are adding sauce. Feel the noodles become a little dry, you can sprinkle some water. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to prepare an egg omelette and then I'm going to stir fry all the other ingredients. So again, heat up the wok with the sesame oil. Make sure there's a little extra amount of oil. Once the oil is nice and hot, add the egg. Scrambled egg, I'm going to add in the ginger and garlic. And continue sauteing. Next, I'm going to add the bok choy, bamboo shoot, colored capsicum, and the spring onion whites. Once the vegetables are sauteed, add in the egg noodles. I'm going to add in the seasoning. I'm going to add some salt. I'm going to add some pepper powder. I'm going to add a little bit of sugar. I'm going to add some vinegar. And very little soy sauce. At the same time, I'm going to sprinkle some water. And it's all ready. And towards the end, I'm going to add spring onion greens. Keep some aside for garnish. The rest of them to be added to the noodles. Lastly, we start by frying the spring rolls, the vegetable spring rolls. The oil should be nice and hot. Drop the spring rolls inside and let it cook on a medium to high flame till it gets nice golden color. The vegetable filling is cooked, so we are only trying to cook the sheet from the outside.